We know now that in the early years of the 20th century, this world was being watched closely by intelligences greater than man's, yet as mortal as his own. We know now that as human beings busied themselves about their various concerns, they were scrutinized and studied, perhaps almost as narrowly as a man with a microscope might scrutinize the transient creatures that swarm and multiply in a drop of water. Serene in the assurance of their dominion over this small, spinning fragment of solar driftwood, which by chance or design, man has inherited out of the dark mystery of time and space. Minds that are Dwar minds, powers of the beasts of the jungle, intellects vast, cool, and unsympathetic, regarded this earth with envious eyes. And slowly and surely drew their plans against us. Were attracted to the immense flock of black birds that hovered directly below me. They circled to the ground. And there before my eyes, dark and silent, lay the Martians with the hungry birds pecking and tearing brown shreds of flesh and dead bodies. Later, when their bodies were examined in laboratories, it was found that they were killed by the putrefactive and diseased bacteria against which their systems were unprepared. Strange to watch the sightseers enter the museum where the dissembled parts of a Martian machine are kept in public view. Strange when I recall the time when I first saw it. Bright, clean cut, hard, silent, under the dawn of that last great day.